California is basically a failed state for years now. It's been suffering under the rule of Democrats, as we've seen increasing crime, literal poop patrols, higher taxes, to the point that people are literally fleeing the state. And California is a blue state. It's run by Democrats. They're fleeing the state and running to red states, like Texas, and ruining those states too. We're going to talk about the failed state of California and these wildfires, which were started by a gender reveal party gone wrong. Hello, everyone. This is Mr. Obvious. And today, on the internet, we're going to talk about all of this. So, here you can see on the Daily Mail, family behind gender reveal firework that sparked huge El Dorado wildfire in California could face the bill for the entire cost of putting the blaze out, as Governor Newsom declares a state of emergency and record temperature of 121 degrees fans the flames. It seems like the perfect storm. California is currently undergoing civil unrest because of riots and so-called mostly peaceful protests, as well as a heat wave, and now these massive fires. Now, for those of you wondering, a gender reveal party is when you're having a baby, you find out the gender of the baby, and then you announce to all your friends, oh, we're gonna have a boy, we're gonna have a girl. I've always hated gender reveal parties because it's pure narcissism. First of all, who cares what gender your kid is? Look, no offense. If your kid's gonna be a girl or boy, you can just tell me. I'm gonna be excited, I'm gonna say cool. But throwing a massive party? You see, this fire started because they bought a pyrotechnic device, and it's supposed to make blue or red smoke. Well, it went wrong, because it lit the entire Southern California on fire. And now they can't keep the lights on. But before we get into this, and I have to show you a tweet from the mayor, a quick word from our sponsor, Double Tap Audio. Are you tired of your headphones breaking? Well, with these headphones, you don't have to worry. Featuring heavy-duty cords and heavy-duty earplugs, these are the headphones for you. They're virtually indestructible and will last a lifetime. It even features magnets, which clip together so that when you're not listening, they don't fall off. You can get the R1 version, which comes in several different styles, for $59.99. Or the DoubleTap R2 modular headphones. These feature interchangeable parts, and even come with expanded options like Bluetooth. Listen to music wirelessly for up to 20 hours with one full charge. Get yours today. Click the link down below in the description. All right, so here we are, folks. I want to show you this tweet from the mayor of Los Angeles, or as I like to say, Los Angeles. It's almost... I'm sorry. This tweet is so funny to me. I'm just going to go ahead and say it, but this is a very cucked thing to say. It's almost 3 p.m. Time to turn off major appliances.
Babe, it's 4 p.m. Time for your dick flattening.
Yes, honey.
Same energy. Now, literally, it's like that meme. It's like, it's almost 3 p.m. Time to turn off your major appliances. You can't tell me that's not exactly the same. Okay, so he goes on to say, set the thermostat to 78 degrees. Or use a fan instead.
Over my dead body.
Turn off excess lights and unplug any appliances you're not using. We need every Californian to help conserve energy. Please do your part. Hashtag flex alert. So, we literally have the mayor of Los Angeles telling its residents, time for your power flattening. We're going to shut off your power. So conserve power instead. Now, California and much of the country is currently through a heat wave. And there's major fires. So why do I call California a failed state? Because it is. It's literally a failed state. They're not even able to keep the power on. People could and will die. Heat waves, and I believe it's hitting up to 120 degrees? That is insane. Now, there's some really ignorant comments in here. PT Stay Home Wear a Mask says, to think there are people who don't believe in global warming. Yeah, except this wasn't caused by global warming, you fool. This was caused by a gender reveal party gone wrong. You could kind of say that about every gender reveal party. Like, it's just obnoxious. That's something to tell me over the phone. I'm not going to, well, is there good food at the party? Okay. Give me some good food, and I'll go to your dumb party. Here's another thing that always got me, like, why does it seem like people who are constantly talking about climate change, they'll say that, you're so dumb. Just because it was really cold, that doesn't mean it's evidence for global warming. But then when it gets really hot, they're like, huh, see? This weather is proof of global warming. Do you see the contradiction there? It's called cherry picking. Weather goes up, weather goes down. Sometimes it's really cold, sometimes it's really hot. It's not necessarily because of climate change. And regardless, there's literally nothing we can do about climate change. Why even worry? John Motter says to the mayor of Los Angeles, show us your thermostat. Ooh, calling him out. I bet you that he's tweeting this, but he has his AC blaring. Because the truth is, these Democrat politicians don't play by the same rules. Rules for thee, but not for me. Here's why this story is totally relevant to why California is a failed state. James Zadvrani says, California energy policy was determined at a state level. Everyone cheered shutting down the nukes and relying on renewables. Backed up by peak power purchases from out of state is a tragic mess. The state, the utility, and the voters did this. Yep, Democrats. You see, Democrats set a lot of bad policies. They got rid of their nuclear energy. And this is how you know that environmentalists are full of crap. Nuclear energy is the best source of energy that we have, and it does not produce greenhouse gases. It produces nuclear waste, but that's something that we can deal with. But environmentalists will say, no, I don't like nukes. We have to go 100% solar and wind, even though that's not enough to power these states. Star Spangled Gambler says, they don't have rolling blackouts in Alabama. Isn't that amazing? And not only that, in Alabama you could get a mansion. Oh my god, what a beautiful quote here. Diego Valequez says, California is a dystopia, thinking itself a utopia. That's the perfect way to describe the Democrats. Man, some of these comments are pure gold. LDS Huxley's ghost says, just showed this warning to my wife. She's a recent immigrant from a third world country. The look on her face was priceless when she realized that California, a major first world economic powerhouse, couldn't keep the power on any better than the country she just left. That's hilarious, but it's also very apt. You know, it's often been said that if you import the third world to your country, you become the third world. California is basically a third world state. It's become a total dump. Part of this is because of illegal immigration, but most of it is due to the Democrats. They refuse to enforce their borders. They institute high taxes and bad social welfare programs and policies, and basically the state is dying. I want you to take a look at this article from USA Today. California is a failed state. How do we know? They're moving to Arizona in droves. You know what the worst part of this is? These Californians, a lot of them are Democrats, and they're going to see that California has a high cost of living, the taxes are high, crime is high, it's dangerous, there's a drought, and they can't even keep the power on. So they leave and then they go to a better state, usually a red state like Texas. And what pisses me off is that they will vote Democrat in Texas, in these red states, and then ruin them. And then they flee from that state and move on to another state to ruin. Here it says, you can't blame Californians for moving to Arizona, but let's hope they leave behind the progressive policies that ruin their state. Absolutely. Now, people are going to call me a total ass for this, but I honestly believe that if you come from a blue state and you're a Democrat and you're trying to move to a red state, I think they should ban you. If these Democrats are going to keep voting Democrat, they're going to suck the red states dry until there's nothing left. Ban them. Let them suffer in the choices they made. In a state like California, where there's a risk of wildfires, what you need to do is controlled burning. You do this by burning areas on purpose in order to clear out, you know, like risk, dry bush, that sort of thing. But California has not been doing this. Why? Because the Democrats have other priorities, like giving healthcare to illegal migrants, or pushing progressive policies, like releasing prisoners from jail, closing down all the businesses, and letting people riot in the streets. And now this family is on the line to pay all of the costs of these fires. I'm talking millions of dollars. Now, California is currently dealing with a record-breaking heat wave. 121 degrees. Oh, man. So, we currently don't have the names of these people, but if they are charged, their names will be released. And, you know, honestly, I want them to suffer. I do. You know, I'm not trying to be mean.
Liar.
But what I'm trying to do... Look, it's really simple. If these people are not punished, then it's only a matter of time before some other moron does a gender reveal party to stroke their own egos and burns down the state again. How about we stop doing this? It's cringy. But that's pretty much the story, my friends. California is a literal hellscape. But that's merely the obvious. Well, that's all for now, folks. What do you think about this story? Let me know down below in the comment section. As always, if you want to support the channel, you can join me on Patreon or Subscribestar. If you want to donate, there's DonorBox and Crypto. And consider checking out my sponsors. There's Double Tap Headphones. There's Virtue Signal The Card Game. Both of them are very excellent products. Check them out in my description. And if you like my content, sharing the video is always a nice and easy way to help. Anyhow, thanks for watching. This has been Mr. Obvious, and I'll see you all next time.